Before we start doing scenes, Shabir has this habit of asking, do you want to do the lines once? And yeah. I haven't heard that in so long. So I miss everyone. I felt so helpless in that moment that I couldn't do this. I started crying.
You ended up crying. Oh boy.
Yeah, and our director is a very, very nice director called Muzamil. Muzamil sir came and he's like, okay, we'll break for lunch. And Shabir just said, come, we'll eat food. And we didn't talk about it. There is no Pragyan of his life, and he has the whole of the world for him. He'll still miss Pragyan. Same for Pragya. It doesn't matter how many people come into her life, what she has.
Hi guys, welcome to Pink Pilla. Today we have the very beautiful and extremely talented Shriti Jha with us. Finally, I think this is the first time she is on Pink Pilla with us. So welcome to Pink Pilla, Shriti. Thank you for doing this.
Thank you, Bhavna, for having me.
You have been associated like with Kumkum Bhagya for the longest time. I mean, you know, I think none of your projects itna zyada waqt koi bhi dusre project ko itna waqt nahi hua tha. So does it ever get monotonous as an actor?
Not really, because fortunately with Kumkum Bhagya, the show or Pragya, which is my character, goes through something really big at least in 6 or 8 months, and there's a complete transformation. So the character keeps evolving, and there are always new things to do. So that's very interesting. Also, I think, especially in a daily soap, that's all I have done. I have this habit of playing each day of a character.
Okay.
And so this happened, and this happened, and this happened, and then there's this big leap, and then again it's one day after another. And I've been very comfortable in that space. So because I have not gotten to do that with any other show, because none of my other shows I have done for more than a year.
Yeah.
So this is my first show where I am in that comfortable space where I have known every day of Pragya. So I'm more comfortable than bored of it.
Right. But are you missing that set? Because, you know, spending half kya, matlab, I think more than half the time there on the set, it becomes your second family. And now the past 2.5 months, there's been no action. There's no one to say cut.
you know what I've missed? So before we start doing scenes, Shabir has this habit of asking, do you want to do the lines once? And I haven't heard that in so long. So I miss everyone. And because we have such a good time shooting for Kumkum Bhagya, so it's a brilliant bunch of people and a fun bunch of people that have come together to make this show. So yeah, I miss everyone. I miss being Pragya.
But tell me, what is your favorite memory of Kumkum Bhagya? It's been what, 4 years or 5 years now, almost?
6 years now.
Six years?
2014 we started.
So 6 years of the show, do you have any one particular memory which is very close to you, or the memory which comes to your mind every time someone says Kumkum Bhagya?
Oh my god, 6 years. It's been practically my life. Kumkum Bhagya has been my life for 6 years. So to chalk out, like to point out one little moment from all that, it's so, so difficult. Oh my god, I can't point out. Every day is full of so many of those moments which make
but
the show.
But do you have any particular scene in mind which was perhaps a little difficult to shoot, or something which perhaps did not, you know, you couldn't understand the scenario per se as Shriti, but you had to do it because obviously that's the character graph.
So, so there was this scene long ago when the show started. There was a scene where Abhi is driving and he splashes mud on me because he's driving his car really fast, and I gave him this long lecture. The scene was really nice. I didn't disagree with the scene. It was a really, really nice scene, really sweet scene. I had this long chunk of line where I tell him that you're going for a concert and you're going to earn what, 4 crore rupees from that concert. My mother's made bhurji. My mother's bhurji is priceless. Go thandi ho gayi na. And it was like a really long chunk of line. And I just couldn't do it. I just, sometimes if I would remember the lines, I wouldn't get the emotion right, and one after the other. And I could see my director was like losing his patience with me, and I had done a lot of takes, and we were shooting in the sun, so there was lots of things happening. So eventually I got, like, I felt so helpless in that moment that I couldn't do this. I started crying.
You ended up crying. Oh god.
Yeah, and our director is a very, very nice director called Muzamil. Muzamil sir came and he's like, okay, we'll break for lunch. And then, and Shabir just said, come, we'll eat food. And we didn't talk about it. We just ate food and we broke. And then we came back to set. And I hope this scene went well. I don't know if people liked it, but I tried to do it.
But I have to ask you, on sets, I mean, Abhi and Pragya as an on-screen couple is much loved. How do you see them, their graph? How do you, see it?
I can't see it objectively because it's so close to my heart.
Of course.
See,
yeah.
I think Abhi and Pragya are very, very, very good friends. And as much because Kumkum Bhagya is about fate and the twist of fate that has got the two of these very unlike each other people together.
Yeah.
And but they are helplessly attracted to each other and they understand each other like no one else does. So
right.
There is no Pragya in Abhi's life and he has the whole of the world for him, he'll still miss Pragya. And same for Pragya. It doesn't matter how many people come into her life and what she has. If Abhi is not there, there is a vacuum in her space. And I think they together make each other cool.
You know, how has your equation with Shabir evolved over the 6 years? Because obviously the chemistry we see on screen is also a byproduct of the camaraderie that you share off screen, right?
Totally, so, totally. I'm very fortunate to have a co-actor like Shabir. Shabir is very, very spontaneous. So that has contributed a lot to creating that chemistry. And over the last 6 years, I have sort of caught on to that spontaneity. Because before Kumkum, I wasn't that spontaneous an actor. But now I try to be and I think I'm getting there. So yeah, that helps. And we have, because we have so much history to now put in every scene that the scene glows because of the history also. Also the way the character was etched by the writers, both the characters. And how they have grown together, how they have been comfortable being friends, fighting. They've been in this awkward married relationship. Then there have been children. Now there are children, but they miss each other. So there has been growth vis-a-vis writing also. Also, Shabir and I have become better friends over the years. So
of course,
that comfort really reflects on screen.
That's for sure. But how often then not do you guys have disagreement when it comes to a particular scene? Kabhi hota hai
Shabir and I?
No, with the writers.
There are sometimes we have disagreements. I have disagreements, but thankfully it's been a very collaborative show where the actor, like we get to speak to our writers, and if there is something that we're not convinced about, we try to change it. But it goes the other way also, that we also have a lot of faith in the writers because they have got it right for a really long time. So there's something
true
that they're doing right.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's a bit of both. They have disagreements with us, we have, but it's a collaborative effort and that is what will happen. And everything
that's
is for the show. The show should look nice.
So now, what are the kind of shows that you are watching during this quarantine period? What has really like struck a chord with you?
The one show that has really struck a chord with me is BoJack Horseman on Netflix.
Okay.
I think it's a really, really well-written show. I think it's my therapy. It's my therapy. I think I identify with so many characters on that show. So that show I have really loved.
So now, I also want to know, web is the new thing right now. Everyone is hooked on to web and they want to work in web also, right? Are there any plans? How do you look at it?
I love the content that is happening on the web in India right now. There are so many good shows and good work is happening, and there's a certain amount of freedom. I think the writers are getting to write what they want, and the creators are getting to create what they want. So I'd love to be in that space, but you can't really plan anything in the choice of career that I've made. So yeah, I'd love to do something like that if it happens.
Right. But do you have any reference in mind? Of course, you have said antagonist is one, that you want to play an antagonist. But apart from that, is there anything else, like a character perhaps in mind, which you would like to play? Something similar?
No, not really. I can't really point out one thing that I really want to play. Everything, yeah. I want to play everything.
This brings me to this non-payment of dues is actually a very sore subject right now, because people are, I read so many reports of people committing suicide because they did not have money left with them. How do you see the situation? Because in television, I know as a matter of fact, ki wo jo credit dates hote hain, there's a huge gap between work and payment, right? How do you see this change post this, perhaps?
I think most people are trying to pay out people right now because it is a difficult time. So people are trying to pay out as far as I know. And it is a very difficult time. What we need to consider is that we are fragile beings. So we have to put it out there that we are available. We have to talk to all our friends. Let them know that we are there. Constantly talk. If there's a problem, reach out for help. There are, I think I have put up a thing on my story today. There are organizations that are only helping artists. They are giving grocery for artists which are not being available, being able to buy groceries right now. Because ours is a very uncertain industry. True. You have a job today, you don't. And right now, you can't even audition for something. So it is a really, really difficult time. But there is hope. There is hope. There are organizations that are continuously helping only for artists. So I have posted about it online. I will post again. So reach out for help. Don't be scared, shy for asking for help. It is a difficult time and we need to stick together and fight this.
That's so true. Thank you so much, Ridhi, for talking to me.
Thank you, Bhavna.
It was a pleasure, really.
No, it was a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you so much.